I was driving out through Mitchell, heard a lonesome railroad whistle, so I stopped beside the highway for a spell. And in this pleasant glade was a notice well displayed with the story I am now about to tell. The notice was a roll of those who'd paid the toll while working on the railroad to the west. Wives and workers perished with the children that they cherished, and in lonely graves were gently laid to rest. Then I found my vision misted, as among the many listed, the name of Clara Waters caught my eye. I imagined my own daughter in the place of Clara Waters, while the busy highway traffic hurtled by. How short her life had been, she was only 17, yet her story may be very simply told. A doctor might have saved her from the fever after labor. Her baby died when he was 4 days old. Then the scene before me shifted, as back in time I drifted, as back in time 100 years I went. And through my muddled dreaming, a morning sun came beaming on a battered billy steaming by a tent. For here was pretty Clara, with her husband there to share a simple meal before their daily tasks. I'm anxious now to meet her, so I hurry on to greet her with the questions that I feel I have. And when the day is breaking, is there happiness in waking? Have you had your share of laughter, joy and cheer? You were very young to marry, and the baby that you carry, does it make you wish your mother could be near? In the coolness of the morning, in the pickaninny dawning, does your husband tell you often of his love? While the magpie's merry singing in the higher branches ringing is bringing morning greetings from above. Does the gentle evening breeze wave the smoke up through the trees? Do you see the shafts of sunlight drifting down? Or has drudgery and duty made you blind to every beauty, while the camp is turning dusty, bare and brown? With a bed of planks and sacking, and with every comfort lacking, growing heavy as your time is roaring near, in your shabby tent so dreary, or are you very often weary? And do you sometimes shed a silent, lonely tear? And when her son was born on a hot December morn, and the deadly fever started on its quest, was there time for her to hold him and in her love enfold him? Was there time to give him comfort at her breast? Of course there's no reply to my questions and my prying, and suddenly I know it's time to go. But I reckon I'll remember what happened that December in the summertime 100 years ago. And then a road train passes, there's a ripple through the grasses, as if to wave a fleeting sad goodbye to Clara and her son, their lives so briefly run, and the busy highway traffic rushes by.